I wanted to ask, Olu, do you actually believe in, was it
monogamy?
Monogamy.
Yeah, I just said it's underrated. I feel like
you said it's underrated, but do you believe in it? Would you do it yourself?
Oh, yeah.
But, like, marry one girl, but, stick with her for the rest of your life.
Just girlfriend.
Don't go that far.
Oh, definitely. Definitely. It depends, isn't it? Because you'd have to find the girl whereby she's
worthy.
Completely worthy. Not saying that I'm at that stage yet, but.
Well, I thought you didn't believe in marriage.
Why? In its current form. Because in its current form, no.
Why not?
What do you mean in its current form?
Why? Because you want to cheat?
No, because the state of marriage is in a good state at the moment. It's just like,
what does that even mean, fam?
Like, when I look at the state of the family per se,
okay.
The rates of divorce are very high.
Yeah, I get you.
It's about 50%.
I get you.
Particularly in the West, it's very high. So perhaps if I was, I don't know, in Niger, where there's a better culture of a family unit, I'd probably be more inclined
to
get wifed up there.
In a relationship. Do you kind of mean, like, where it's a different society here compared to, let's say, Nigeria, like, there's less outward things that could distract you?
Distractions, yeah.
But man, them can cheat anywhere, though. This is what I mean. It's that same notion when girls are like, oh yeah, you can let your boy go on a lad's holiday. It's like, bro, it's like, if man wants to cheat on you, I could do it in
anywhere.
I could do it in Scarborough. I could do it in Isle of Wight. I could do it in Jersey. I could do it in Ibiza. You know what I mean? Like, the location, if a man wants to cheat, he's going to do it regardless.
But it's more likely it does that have you an effect, cheat, though. On holiday, it's more likely for you to cheat on holiday because it's a better environment to cheat. Let's not lie. Sunny, more alcohol in your system.
Optimum environment.
It basically is girls and vibes that are willing to do it.
Yes, the energy. The energy's different on holiday.
The vibes are different. You can say the same for clubbing, though.
No, but clubbing's like long because you either have to go to your house or her house, or you probably see someone that you know because you're at home.
If you're OT,
exactly. So you have to be away. You have to be on holiday or something.
I mean. So just basically, you can't do it in your hometown.
You can't. You have to go I don't know, but I've been told that you have to go away if you want to cheat, but
it's nuts.
I'm not taking notes.
But
just duly noted in your head. Good advice for Lavin. You sound like an expert.
You know the ones who pens it down, not actually like pins it down. But what's your opinion on monogamy?
No, I believe in it. I'm totally for it. See my parents as an example, and also because obviously it's a Christian practice, is it? That's what it teaches. That's it, really.
Well,
you just have to find the right one that you know you want to settle down with for the rest of your life.
But how do you know it's the right one? That's the thing I keep thinking. Like, how do you know that is?
I think some of those ones whereby you just.
Yeah, it'll be like a gut feeling.
Yeah. And for guys, it takes them a while longer compared to girls. Because girls can instantly know, whereas guys, it'll take them.
Girls always think that the guy they meet is the one. That's the thing. Because that's the way they set up.
In what way?
In what way?
They set up. Like for us, yeah, ambition goal wise, okay, you want to get a car, you want to get a house, you want to get a family or something like that. That's what we build up for. The girls from like birth, they've been thinking about marriage, their wedding, having kids. Those are the goals that they compare themselves amongst their friends. They think, she just got married. Oh, I'm happy for her.
Want the biggest.
That's
ring
what they
as
want.
Well.
You know, that's what they want. The biggest ring. That's what they want.
Their baby shower.
That's exactly.
That's their goal thing.
Those are their goals.
So, I was talking to also called Mariana about it.
Yeah,
and I was like, marriage is, it's weird, like, when you actually deep, like, the wedding day, and marriage is more for the woman than the man. Like, it's always meant for both parties. No, think about it, yeah.
The wedding, yeah, the reception, I want to take control of.
You're not.
Reception, I want it to be a party.
Though, it's like, sorry, not marriage, the wedding, like, or wedding, sorry, is more for the woman than the man.
It is.
Because all the focus is on the woman. And, like, Nick Cannon was saying it as well, he was saying, like, he was just deep in it all, like, girls from a young age, they've been thinking about the massive wedding dress, like you said.
Exactly.
And, like, the flexing of the wedding ring, you know, like, guys don't really do that on social media. It's like, you know what it is as well? Because like, if a guy was to tell you he got married, another guy, you wouldn't look at yourself and be like, wow, like, fucking hell, like, you wouldn't feel to look at yourself and be like, all right, cool, I need to get a move on. But I feel like if it's the other way around, if like,
yeah,
a girl getting married and someone around her age is, then she might be like,
she'd be looking at you like,
like,
where's my video?
Yeah, where's mine? Like,
don't you love me as well?
Especially if your relationship is going on for a similar, especially like if your relationship's been going on for like a similar length of time as theirs. I mean, so like, if your relationship, let's say if you had one was going on for like 5 years and mine was 5 years, and let's say if I'm married, there's a chance that your girlfriend might feel a bit more inclined to be like, rah, like, okay, like, he's taking a step, like, okay.
So he puts pressure on everyone.
You know what I mean?
He puts pressure on everyone.
It's interesting, though.
It's nuts because this whole marriage thing is like, for example, I know a guy that was, it's not that he wanted to get married, but it's the fear of divorce, isn't it? And the thing is that with divorce, it's not just separate from the relationship. It's the state as well. And it's what you've worked for and it's your possessions. So I think a lot more guys would be inclined to get married if they weren't so fearful of getting divorced.
Would you get a prenup though?
No. If I was thinking about getting a prenup, I just would not get married.
Yeah, that's what I said as well. Yeah, that's what I said.
Or you can always do a sham marriage in Nigeria where there's no papers.
But you know, and uncles have got that as well. You know, sad.
You know that. You know them ones where you're just sitting down. You got some peanuts in the middle of the table. A pasta paste for you.
Some pop off,
and that's
well.
It.
Maybe some Flemish on the side.
That's it.
That's your wedding done.
Them ones where the pop offs because it's overseas.
Fam, that's how it used to be back in the day. Yeah. And if you think about it, it was way more successful. There was no 30 grand weddings. There was no Beamer outside waiting for you with like paparazzi, the whole thing.
But remember, there were no Louis Vuitton shoes. Them man moved differently. Everyone had two or three different wives. The men were toxic back then.
Like my own
different wives. Different
fam, there's some benefits to this toxicity that you're talking about.
I'm telling you.
Because marriages were lasting longer.
True. So the world was a better place,
but
you know?
But it wasn't happy marriage though.
It was always love.
For the woman, bro.
And so?
As spoken by the chairman of the League of Extraordinary
Toxic Gentlemen. No, I'm not that bad. I'm a good boy, man. Good boy.
Monogamy, fam.